During the commemoration ceremonies, the city opened a vastly expanded memorial to the victims. Several thousand doves were released. The incident, often referred to as the Rape of Nanking, has for years strained relations between Japan and China. This year, on the 70th anniversary, several movies and documentaries are re-examining this bitter past. One of these films is by Lu Chuan, the director who previously made the award-winning Coco Xili. His film, Nanking, Nanking, is being made with state approval and support. With Sino-Japanese relations and trade improving, and with memories of recent anti-Japanese riots on its mind, the Chinese government is presently treading carefully on the subject. Trade relations are a priority. It took him around 5 months and a lot of help from the higher echelons to convince the censors.
这个 censorship 不是说那种铁板一块的，就是你要 convince 他们。我觉得这很重要，不管怎么样说，现在虽然提了意见，我也就要去改。但是有一条线是日本人的线，从他的那个角度去拍，接受了。我觉得诚信吧也蛮重要的。这个，尤其这样的东西，你剧本写一套，你拍一套，可能不能这样做。所以我就花了很多时间就跟他们聊。 我说你将来这个戏就拍给中国人自娱自乐，好像不太好吧？我们一定要打到日本去，让日本人convince日本人。On
this 70th anniversary, it's not just China and Japan that have been remembering the Nanking Massacre. This year, there seems to be a Nanking movie coming out of every continent. A documentary directed by Canadian husband and wife team Ann Pick and Bill Spehick, Irish Chang, The Rape of Nanking, tells the story through the eyes of a Chinese-American writer. The first edition of her book on the incident was criticized for inaccuracies, but it did increase international awareness. A German production featuring Ulrich Turkor from The Lives of Others and indie actor Steve Buscemi tells the story of John Rabe, a German businessman who used his Nazi connections to save Chinese civilians. The $20 million movie will be released in Germany next year. Hong Kong's Yim Ho says it's taken him a few years to get government permission to film in China. But he is now in pre-production on Nanking Christmas 1937, a Hollywood production with a $35 million budget. The American documentary Nanking recounts the massacre through the eyes of the Westerners who remained in the city during the war. The film was entirely financed by the AOL's vice president, Ted Leonsis. When it opened in Nanjing in July, local benefactors bought thousands of tickets and distributed them to the public for free. Feeling threatened by the merit of films they see as anti-Japan, that nation's nationalists have come up with their own version, The Truth About Nanjing. It denies all accounts of the massacre and claims all the evidence to be faked. Compared to the other big productions, the small $2 million film, planned to be released next spring, is not likely to garner much attention outside Japan. Lu Chuan's Nanking Nanking team is currently building a replica of the old city walls and some areas of the city. They are shooting in Tianjin and in Changchun.
大部分是从真人的故事改编的，你比如说日本兵的这个故事，那我就去看了很多日本人写的日记，但它不是一个人的事情，它是很多很多日本老兵的事情，然后呢放在一个人身上，因为我觉得我编我很难去编出来，就是我觉得你要有那种现实感的话，就必须要去获得他们那种第一手的资料。 我是学军事的，我在看资料的时候，其实我不是一个容易相信别人话的人。我就把所有中国大陆，这几十年曾经印刷出来的，所有的关于南京的。 这种资料尽量的都拿到，然后看书，看看看看看，然后你就会发现，的确很多人说的话都是不一样的，就是这个蛮可怕的，你知道吧？你以前觉得哎呦板上钉钉的东西，可是你不能把它推论出来。就后来我就去请一些朋友在日本拿资料，拿了日本的纪录片。我开始的时候是一个强烈的民主主义者，很像那种街头扔石块的青年学生那种状态。可是现在我觉得我状态就是说，因为我觉得我看到了大量的事实，大量的历史，我觉得我真的形成了自己的一个观念。我突然觉得，就是我觉得做这部电影的最大的最重要的是让人看到了，不是说是要让人自己去反省，让所有的观众去反省。因为那种丑恶实际上就是在战场上随意杀人，随意掠夺别人的生命，随意掠夺女人的这个贞操，是可能是每一个男人都藏在心中的一段，这种东西是藏在每一个男人身，只是你没有机会去展现。所以就是因为我看了很多很多日本人的日记，他们在家里边都是很好的很 nice 的人，到中国战场上一点一点的，因为他没有法律去约束他，他可以随便杀人，随便去抢劫，随便强奸，那慢慢的他就 enjoy 这种功，因为他的权力变得无限大。如果我们就是讲屠杀，讲血淋淋的场面，然后在那儿画一个句号 ，OK， 那我就觉得拍这部电影没有意义。这个电影最有意思的就是讲普通人怎么会在中国就干那个魔鬼干的事情，这个才是最有意思的，而不是要去讲一个魔鬼怎么经常干魔鬼干的事情。
The subject remains sensitive. It remains to be seen what impact the various productions will have on the relations between the two countries.As political realities change, what can be said is likely to change too. For his part, Lu Chuan has situated his studio in Beijing's Japanese neighborhood so that his team can live and interact with Japanese people every day.
就是我不想把它拍成就是一个喊口号的电影，去点燃仇恨的电影，因为这样的话这部电影其实是远离我现在的初衷的。我真的是想让它变成一部让大家思考的电影，这样才有意思。就是我希望能做到这一点。